From News 8 WMTW-TV, this is a News 8 Now update.
Good evening and welcome back to News 8 Now. I'm Megan Torgerson. Today marked the official start of the second annual Dempsey Challenge. It's a two-day run, walk, and cycling event that raises money for the Patrick Dempsey Center for Cancer, Hope, and Healing. More than 4,000 people have registered for this weekend's Dempsey Challenge to raise money for a center that helps families cope with cancer. One of today's events included a news conference at the Portland Yacht Club to honor the many sponsors of the Dempsey Challenge. Patrick Dempsey, Maine native and founder of the event, took plenty of time to greet people and pose for photos. He says the challenge is a great event for cancer survivors, their families, and for Maine.
To it. I think there is a sense of pride that we all share about our community, and it's wonderful. And then I really love cycling, and I think it promotes cycling in Maine.
Organizers of the Dempsey Challenge say it's not a race. They want people to come out and have a good time. They say thanks to all of the sponsors, 100% of the money raised goes to the center. A state lawmaker has pleaded guilty to a charge of operating under the influence. The charge stems from a crash in August when his car rolled over on I-295 in Freeport. Sean Flaherty, who represents Scarborough in the Maine House, entered the plea Friday. Flaherty says in a statement that he sees the accident as a, quote, humbling and important lesson and is grateful that no one was hurt. He also apologizes to his constituents in the statement. Police say Flaherty originally told them he swerved to miss an animal, bounced off a guardrail, lost control, went off the road, and flipped his car. A 32-year-old man is dead after an ATV crash in north central Maine. Wardens say Alfred Shaw from the town of Derby died when he lost control of his ATV on a wet leaf-covered trail in Brownville Junction. He was thrown off it and was found unconscious on the trail. Wardens say this is the second serious ATV wreck in less than a week. Last weekend, a woman from Blanchard suffered serious head injuries when she drove her ATV off an embankment, falling 25 feet into a small stream. Bargain shoppers were able to open their wallets for a good cause today. Dress for Success hosted a women's clothing sale and fundraiser this afternoon. Everything from shoes and accessories to casual wear and business suits were available at a discounted price. It took place at the Mill Creek Shopping Plaza in South Portland, and all the proceeds from the sale go to Dress for Success, an organization dedicated to giving disadvantaged women the tools they need to succeed. That includes both professional attire and an emotional support system.
It's great. It's really a rewarding experience for me. About 25 years ago, I had a hardship in life, and money was very hard. And I wish that there had been something like this for me when I was trying to get back into the workforce.
Dress for Success helps women in more than 100 cities across the United States. It's helped about 500,000 women since it was founded more than 10 years ago. Thank you for joining us here on News 8 Now. I'm Megan Torgerson. Stay with us for the latest weather and sports highlights. We'll be right back.